So that is an amalgam, which is a spiritual substitute for this Mercury, and it is known as Brahmarantra Sita. So this Brahmarantra Sita Tejas is in the form of a semi-fluid, and it is in the governance of Medha, Yashas, Pratibha and Smriti. Knowing things, everybody can know a lot of things, but some sort of special operations of mind is possible only by this thing. Intensive mind is there, abysmal mind is there, obscure mind is there, clandestine mind is there, abstruse mind is there, peripheral mind is there, and something to understand about the future, that is what we call Aghata Darshana, understanding the depth, Dura Darshana, understanding about future, Samagra Darshana, because there is an invention divined by a scientist. I have devised it for me. What will be the impact of this thing on others? He cannot think. Only after getting the ill effects, he will think that he has made a mistake. So like that, Dura Drishti, Aghada Drishti, Sara Drishti, getting the essence. All of these type of knowledge is governed only by spiritual wisdom, which is in the form of Brahmarantra Tejas. And for protecting the Brahmarantra Tejas, there must be a tension. The tension is created by a tuft. The tension should have a particular unit of pressure. If it is having more pressure, then that is useless. Then if it is having a limitless pressure, which is beneath the level of pressure required, that is also there. It is known as Karshana. So Shika is Shakti Rakshanaya Keshasya Karshanam Shika Ita Vidiyate. Brahmananda Tejas is there for persons who are understanding Vedas, uttering Vedas and performing the rituals. They need more Shita Tejas and they need more spiritual inborn power. For governance of such power, there needs a spiritual tension, and for creating that tension within the proximate area, four finger space in the front head and four finger space in the back head, that is removed, that is known as Parityakta. If you remove this area, starting from this area, if you create a tuft and create a pressure, that created pressure will have a gravity center at our plexus chakra, the Brahmarantra Dwara, wherein by the Shitala is maintained with the potency. It is having a static power. You know that 6th standard you might have done the comb and paper exercise in your physics lesson of 6th standard. Like that, it is having some energy. That type of energy is known as Keshasakti. Kesha and Naka, they are having definite energies. Keshaha Nakaha Ujasya Shakti Vrayahetuhu. By preserving this Kesha and Naka, we can develop Ujas. By not properly preserving or cutting whenever it is not to be, we can also lose our energy. But now we need not worry because we don't have any energy at all. No, that's what I told in the lecture. These type of things are, see, helmet is meant for two-wheelers. Helmet is meant, if the person is not going to ride or not having the vehicle, what is the use of the helmet? If you have a purpose, a destination of getting given energy or realization, if you are into that practice, if you want to protect that, then for that all of these things are utilized. Otherwise it has no use. Then it is known as Chaula. Then that is Vidyarambha. Vidyarambha has three things. One is Akshara Rekana. Second is Akshara Bodha. Third thing is Karna Bodha. There are three centers of knowledge. The first input center is your ear. Second output center is your tongue. Third output center is in the form of Lipi, that is your finger. It is known as Vani, it is known as Lipi, and what we grasp is known as Shabda. So we receive it as Shabda, develop it to Vani, or write it in the form of Lipi. So there is one input, and the second input is Mana, mind. There are two input devices, mind and ear, two output devices. One is the tongue, second is the script writing finger, the hand. So these three guidances are given by the teachers. See, now recently there was a report. The teachers are boresome and they cannot compete or they cannot create a compensation to the female, very much polite, very much humble, at the time of self-defense, at the time of safeguarding her son, at the time of safeguarding her husband. He creates masculinism, she secretes masculinism. Huh? That type of an androidite secretion is inculcated inside that male, that female, at the time of self-defense, etc. We know that. So these are some qualities, circumstantial qualities. And you know that all living beings, God only is the Paramapurusha, and all spiritual particles, they are feminine in nature because of their subservience. And in safeguarding the nation and in safeguarding the culture, each and everybody should have a masculinism. So these things are known as sandarbhika guna or circumstantial instincts which will be provoked at the time of circumstances. If not provoked, there must be some inner harmonic deficit which should be cured by proper divine treatment. If your feminine could not get the masculism at the time of self-defense, if you are a sadhu, if we cannot get that masculism or bravery at the time of protecting the dharma, and if a person who is masculine, a wrestler, a very great potential person, cannot create the politeness and submission at the time of being surrounded by divine persons in the darbar, in the sabha of divine people or learned people, if we cannot create that quality, then that is a hormonal, divine hormonal imbalance. You have to achieve that. So this Pumsavana is not only mentioning that we would get only male children, but it is also implying that apart from, if everybody is born male, already there is misproportionate gender positions in all areas. If everybody, once again they perform Pumsavana and this male gender is more hyper quantitalized, then what is the possibility for proper marriage? You have to go for bigamy, trigamy and polygamy. There is no other way. So what is the option? The Pumsavana that not only gives the idea that we have to get male children, it also gives the idea that we could get masculine children, courageous children, those who can protect the dharma, those who can protect our culture, those who can protect the family. So it is both male in gender or masculine or courageous in nature. Third thing is Simanto Nayana. Simantaha Unniyate Yena Karmana Tat Karma Simanto Nayana. By means of these things, what they do? They take a divine bath and then they do one Prajapati Homa and three bunches of Darbha with one this porcupine quill, with three bunches of Udumbara, which we call fig, Udumbara, with unripe fruits, they are taken and they are placed and mantras are chanted by the Simantonena. It is Garbha Samrakshana. It is Garbha Samrakshana. At the time of the third month, Pumsavana is being done. Even the science says that visible genital organic construction is substantially constructed only at the age of 3 months. Only starting from 3 months, visible or constructive placement of the genital organs are being made inside the embryo. So at that time, the third month, they will do Pumsavana. And Simantonayana should be done at the age of, at the period of 7 or 8 months. And Sushruta mentions here one shloka. It is very interesting here. Panchame manaha pratibuddha dharam bhavati shatte buddhihi. The ability to think of the child will blossom at the period of 5 months. And ability of the thinking to develop into intellect. Manaha is, that is ability to think, cognize. Ability to think about what it has thought is intellect. What is the difference between mind and intellect? Ability to cognize is mind. Ability to cognize about what it has cognized is intellect. For example, I have seen this. It is cognition. My mana says that it is book. I have understood it. That is cognized. But intellect says, what is the name of the book? What is it concerned with? The deeper you go, you get more additional information. That is known as intellect. So it is to think about the thought. So, Satte buddhihi panchame manaha pratibuddhataram bhavati. So says Sushruta. So at this age, at this 7 or 8 months, it is a proper period for us to do that simantonayana, by which the embryo is made sturdy, it is made free from abortion or any prenatal diseases. Most of the people, you see that they are born as mentally retarded, born with a lot of hormonic imbalances. The person properly governed with simantonayana is having reduced possibilities to get into postnatal or intranatal or prenatal diseases. That is Simantonayana. Then we are having Jatakarma at the time of disconnecting the umbilical cord or the navel connectivity of the child. It should be done. That is Jatakarma. That is done for removing all the Kashmalas. Kashmala means all the other advantageous toxins and venoms which are visibly removed by various other antitoxins or the other medical applications. They remove only tangible things. All the other subtle things which may govern future diseases at the time of growing, everything is prevented. So Balarishtas, all the other diseases that are imminently having the possibility to take its shape at the time of its adolescence or that adulthood or infantry, they are all prevented. All the other prenatal and postnatal diseases, innate inborn diseases, they are prevented by means of this Simantonayana. So this Jatakarma is also